Dear children, welcome to this channel. Shall we see the graph of secant function and its inverse today? Now, what is secant x? Secant x is nothing but the reciprocal of cos x. Okay. So, what would be the domain of the secant x? Already I have explained this, but let me repeat it. What is the domain of secant x? You have to give the values for x in such a way that cos x is not equal to 0. If cos x is equal to 0, then secant x doesn't exist. Okay, so you have to give the values for x in such a way that cos x is not equal to 0. So for what values of x cos x would be 0? Let us see that. Okay, you know that cos 90 pi by 2 is equal to 0, and then cos 3 pi by 2 equal to 0, etc. Cos 5 pi by 2 equal to 0, etc. And this is the positive direction, that is in the anti-clockwise direction. And if you measure the angle in the clockwise direction, that is the negative direction, it will be cos of minus pi by 2 equal to 0, cos minus 3 pi by 2 equal to 0, cos of minus 5 pi by 2 equal to 0. So in general, cos of 2n plus 1 into pi by 2 is equal to 0, where n belongs to z. So for these values, cos will be 0. So for these values, secant doesn't exist. Secant doesn't exist. So in order to get the domain of the secant function, you have to remove these values for which cos x would be equal to 0. So what is the domain of secant function? R minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, n belongs to z. Okay. So for these values, cos x is equal to 0, and hence secant x does not exist. So removing this, the remaining would be the domain for the secant function. Okay. Now let us see what would be the range of the secant function. Again, as in the case of cosecant, we are going to get the write down some values of angles from 0 to 2 pi for a period 0 to 2 pi and the corresponding values of pi. Okay. So for a 0 degree, what is cos 0? Cos 0 is 1, and hence secant 0 is also 1. Then in the cosecant we took 30 degree, but here we are going to take 60 degree because cos 60 will be 1 by 2 and hence secant will be 2, an integral value. So in order to avoid a fractional value, we are going to choose the angle 60 degree in such a way that the secant will be an integral value. So we have chosen the angle 60 degree. So for 60 degree, what is the secant value? 2. Then for 90 degree, that it is for pi by 2, cos 90 is 0 and hence secant will be equal to infinity. Then for the angle in the to choose an angle in the second quadrant, I have taken again 180, 120 degree. Why? Because 120 degree means this is nothing but 180 minus 60. So you have to take the 60 degree. So you have to use the 60 degree. That's why we have taken 120 degree. So what is cos of 120 degree? Cos of 120 degree is cos of 180 minus 60. But for angles in the second quadrant, the cos ratio will be negative. So it will be equal to minus cos 60 and hence it is minus 1 by 2. So by taking reciprocal to get the value of secant, it would be equal to minus 2, right? Then for pi, that is 180 degree, cos value will be minus 1. That is known. Again, to find the value of one angle in the third quadrant, again we are going to take this 60 degree. So I have taken 240 because 240 is nothing but 180 plus 60. Now what is cos of 240? Cos of 240 is equal to cos of 180 plus 60. Again, for the third angles in the third quadrant, cos will be negative, that is equal to minus cos 60 and hence it is minus 1 by 2 and therefore the secant value will be minus 2. So we are getting an integral value. That's why we are choosing the angles in such a way to get an integral value. Okay. Then for 270 degree, 3 pi by 2, the value of infinity as cos 3 pi by 2 is 0, secant will be infinity. Then to find out an angle in fourth quadrant, I have taken 300 because 300 is nothing but 360 minus 60. The same 60 has been used. So what is cos of 300? Cos of 300 is nothing but cos of 360 minus 60. But for angles in the fourth quadrant, cos will be positive. That is equal to cos 60, which is equal to 1 by 2. And hence, secant value will be 2, an integral value. And for cos 360 degree 2 pi, it is equal to 1. Okay, do you understand this? So with the help of this, we are going to draw the, find out the range. And then with the help of that, let us plot the graph. Okay. So, if you take the represent the values along the number line, For 0 to 90 degree, that is for angles in the first quadrant, it has been increasing from 1 to infinity. So the value has been increasing, the secant x increases from 1 to infinity. And then for 90 to 180, again, look here, minus in infinity, again minus 2, minus 1. That means it had been increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. Don't refer this infinity here. From minus infinity, it has been increasing to minus 1. Because plus infinity doesn't go to minus 1, crossing this minus 2, negative value. So minus infinity, it has been increasing for the angles in the second quadrant. Then for the angle in the third quadrant, that is 180 to 270, again minus 1, minus 2 decreasing. So it has been decreasing to minus infinity. Then for the angles in the fourth quadrant, 270 to 360, again look at here, infinity to 1, it has been decreasing from plus infinity to 1. So this is the range. This is the range of the secant x. So the value of x doesn't exist between minus 1 to plus 1. So what is the range of secant x? R minus open interval minus 1 to 1, or minus infinity, open and minus infinity closed at 1, union closed at 1 to, sorry, minus infinity to minus 1 and closed at 1 and open at infinity. So this is the range, right? So using this, we are going to draw the graph. Now, taking the angles along the x-axis and the values along the y, values along the y-axis, that is 1, 2, 3, etc. to plus infinity and minus 1 to minus infinity along y-axis, and the angles 0, etc. to 0, pi by 2, pi to 3, pi by 2 along x-axis, positive x-axis, and 0, minus pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3, pi by 2, etc. along the negative axis, we are going to draw the graph, right? Now, see, look at this. For the angles in the first quadrant, the value has been increasing from 1 to infinity. And moreover, at 0, the value is 1. So at 0, it is 1. And for 60 degree, it is 2. Somewhere at 60 degree, here it is 2. And then it has been increasing. So you have to draw the graph like this, increasing, right? It is increasing in this part, right? So from 0 to pi by 2, it has been increasing. And then from then, as cos of minus pi by 3 is also equal to cos pi by 3, we have in the negative side also, we have cos of minus pi by 3 is 2, and therefore here somewhere minus pi by 3 it will be 2. So in this direction it is also increasing. So this is a part of the graph in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay. And then coming to the next part, pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Here, look at, see, by 90 to 180, it has been increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. So, from minus infinity to minus 1, it has been increasing, crossing some minus 2 here. Crossing minus 2, it has been increasing. Again, for the angle 180 to 270, it has been decreasing. From minus 2, minus 1 to infinity, it has been decreasing. So, from minus 1 to minus infinity, it has been decreasing. So, this is the graph in this part, that is, in this interval, minus pi, plus pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Similarly, so this is the graph. And then, here also, as the cos of minus x is equal to cos x, the same will get repeated. Because cos of minus x is equal to cos x. So, as what would be the value of cos of minus pi? That would be equal to cos pi, which is equal to minus 1. So, here the same point will be marked here. Likewise, we have to draw all the points. And then if you draw it, we will get the graph like this. So, this is the graph of the secant function. So, it looks like the same of cosecant, but a little difference. There it lies in between 0 to pi, but here it lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Again, let us see what are the properties exhibited by this graph means. Look at this graph. Is it continuous throughout? No, because it has us at a it has been discontinuous at the point pi by 2, minus pi by 2, 3, minus 3 pi by 2, and 3 pi by 2, and so on. So, the graph is not continuous throughout. Okay. So, it has a vertical asymptotes at x is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. It has a vertical asymptote. And then it has neither maximum nor minimum, and hence no amplitude. And whether it is even or odd function means, you know that cos function is an even function and hence secant is also even function. Even by looking at the graph, we can say that it is an even function. Why? Because it is symmetric about y-axis. The portion to the left of y-axis and the right of y-axis looks like same and therefore is similar. Therefore, it is symmetric about y-axis and hence it is an odd function. So, from the graph we can see whether it is an odd function or an even function by looking at the symmetry. Here it is symmetric about y-axis and therefore it is an even function. Also, you know that it is a cos is an even function and hence secant is an even function. And then, what is the period? It has a period at 2 pi. Here you know that cos x is a period function with a period 2 pi and hence secant x is also a periodic function with period 2 pi. That is also observed by the graph because for a length, the period of length 0 to 2 pi, the portion of the graph gets repeated again and again. See, look at this. From minus pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. What is the length of the graph here? Length here, it is a length of period 2 pi. So, pi by 2, pi by 2, pi by 2, pi by 2. So, 4 pi by 2 here length. So, 4 intervals of length pi by 2 and hence it is a length of 2 pi. And look at the graph. This is one part is like this and another part looks like this. Again here, again it is a length of period 2 pi. The same portion gets repeated. Similarly, the next portion it will be like this. And hence for a length of 2 pi, the graph gets repeated. Therefore, what is the period of this function? Period of this function obtained by the graph, it is 2 pi. So, by looking at the graph, we can also define the period. The length for which the graph gets repeated is called its period. So, here for a length 2 pi, the graph gets repeated. Therefore, its period is 2 pi. Again, let us see what is the inverse secant function. As usual, the secant function is not a bijective in the entire domain or minus that entire domain. Therefore, we have to choose the domain in such a way that it is bijective. Okay. Now, what is the principal domain for the cos function? The principal domain for the cos function is closed interval 0 to pi. Okay. In between, that is for the angle in the first and second, the cos value doesn't get repeated. So, we choose these two quadrants, that is interval 0 to pi to define the inverse cosine function. As secant function is the reciprocal of a cosine function, again to define the inverse secant function, we have to choose the same interval 0 to pi as the restricted domain. Okay, but except this line, that is at the value x is equal to pi by 2, cos value doesn't exist. That is, cos value is 0. That means secant does not exist. So, except this one, we have to take the other angles. So, what is the restricted domain to define the inverse secant function? Closed interval 0 to pi minus, except this minus pi by 2. That is, except this angle, all other angles to be taken as a restricted domain. Okay. So, in this domain only, we are going to define the inverse secant function. Because in this domain only, the secant function is bijective. And therefore, we can define the inverse secant function. So, how we are going to define the inverse secant function? The secant inverse secant function is defined as secant inverse from the domain R minus the open interval minus 1 comma 1 to this closed interval 0 to pi minus the singleton set pi by 2 given by secant inverse of x is equal to y if and only if secant y is equal to x as usual. And then where should x belongs? X should belongs to this domain and y belongs to this range. Okay. And this domain is called the principal domain of the secant function. This restricted domain is called the principal domain of the secant function. Right. So, where secant, what is the secant has been defined from this function to this range. Again, secant inverse is defined from this domain to this range. Okay. And as usual, this is called the restricted domain. And then using this, let us see how to get the graph of the inverse secant function. And then for corresponding value of x, I have taken only the three integral values, 1, plus 2 and minus 2. And the corresponding angles are, for 1, it will be 0. And for 2, it is pi by 3, that is 60 degree. And for minus 2, it is minus 60 degree. It has been shown earlier. Again, from this, from the tabular column, we have taken these three values. And then by taking the values of plus 1, minus 1, etc., the real numbers along x-axis and the angles along the y-axis, And for 0, for a 1 it would be 0. For 1 the value of y is 0. And for 2 it is pi by 3. And for 2 the angle will be pi by 3 for 60 degree. And for minus pi by 3, minus 2. Minus 2 it would be equal to minus pi by 3. Like that, by joining this point we can draw the graph like this. So the graph would be like this. Okay. So this is the graph of the inverse secant function. We can see that as the secant inverse has the domain r minus minus 1 to 1, we can see that for minus 1 to plus 1, the graph does not exist. That means x doesn't take any value between minus 1 to 1. See, as the domain is minus 1 to 1. All right? Okay.